Hello viewers, welcome in online class for the subject general knowledge for class 5. We are from St. Joseph's Academy, Ghaziabad. Today's topic is scientific instruments and technology talks. Here we will study about scientific instruments. First of all, let us study chapter number 31, scientific instruments. What are scientific instruments? Instruments which are used in science means the instruments which are used by our scientists to measure current, velocity, torque, or to see distant objects. Different instruments are used. They are called scientific instruments. Instruments are like small, complicated machines which are used by the scientists to measure current, velocity, earthquake, direction of wind, torque, and many more things that are called the scientific instruments. Here, we have to identify scientific instruments and write their names. Pictures of the scientific instruments are there. We have to identify them and write their names. The first one, to measure electric current. Which instrument is used to measure electric current? That is called galvanometer. Galvanometer is used to measure electric current. The image is also in front of you. The next instrument is stethoscope. All of you have seen when we are going to doctors. The doctors are using the stethoscope for listening the sound produced by our heart and the lungs. When we are ill, our heart and lungs are working properly. Their sound, their speed of working are listened with the help of stethoscope. After stethoscope, the next one is the instrument which is used, that is seismograph. The seismograph is used to record the intensity of earthquake shocks. The earthquakes are coming. How much is the shock of the earthquake? The speed, the intensity of the earthquake is measured with the help of seismograph. So, seismograph is used to measure the intensity of earthquake. Next one is tape recorder. All of you are very familiar with this word. It is used in recording sound on magnetic tapes and playing back the recording. The tape recorder is used in recording sound on magnetic tape and playing back the recording. That is called tape recorder. This one is binocular. Binocular is used to look distant objects by both eyes simultaneously. If you want to see stars and other distant objects of the space, the scientists are using binoculars. With this binocular, we can see with the both eyes simultaneously. Next is anemometer. Anemometer is used to measure the velocity and finding the direction of the wind. Wind is flowing in the different direction, east, west, north, south. You can look here. There are four round shaped structures are there. which are rotating and telling us the direction of the wind, that in which direction the wind is blowing. That is called anemometer. Radar. It is used to detect the presence of an aircraft submarine. When the aircrafts are submarines, they are used to see that is there anything under the water. That is called a radar. It is used for detecting any submarine thing. Barometer. It is used to measure the atmospheric pressure in our atmosphere. Air pressure is there. How much air pressure is there? That is measured with the help of barometer. This is the round shape like speedometers. Dynamometer. It is used to measure torque and rotational speed of an engine. Engines are rotating. With what speed? What is their torque? That is measured with the help of the scientific instrument that is called dynamometer. Used to measure torque and rotational speed of an engine. With this, the chapter 31, that is scientific instrument, is over. So let us start chapter 32, technotop. So first of all, what is technotop? Students, we are using many technical terms in computer like URL, www, gigabyte, pixel, website, web page, home page. There are many new terms for us. So in this chapter, we will study these technical terms which are used in computers. Because nowadays we all are using computers on the online classes. You are also familiar with many new terms. First one, by radio waves. Does a mobile phone connect to the phone network by radio waves or by a computer? Does a mobile phone connect to the phone network by radio wave or by a computer? The answer is by radio waves. We can connect a mobile phone to the network. Now, next question is, what is a credit card with a computer chip inside card? Credit cards are having, we are having credit cards, debit cards. These cards are having one computer chip inside it. So that is called the smart card. The credit card with the computer chip is called the smart card. What is the format for a web address card? What is the format for a web address card? URL. What is the format called? URL. In the URL, there are the addresses of all the websites. All the unique addresses of the website is called the URL. Now, next question is, who runs the internet? Nobody runs the internet. Is there anybody who runs the internet? No one. Nobody runs the internet. Next question is, what is the name for a secret word you use to connect to the internet? When we are connected to the internet, we are having mail or we are opening our computer, laptop. We are using some password. That is our secret name. So we should not share the password with others. If we share, all can read your things. So keep it secret. What is another name for a portable computer? If the computer is portable, we carry it from one place to another. That is called laptop. laptop easily we can carry. That is a portable computer. Laptops are called portable computers. What is the tiny dot? That is a part of a picture on the computer screen called pixel. The small dots, that is a part of a picture on a computer screen, that is called pixel. Pixel, megapixel, these are there. These terms are there. What is the full form of ISP? ISP. I is for internet. S, service. P for provider. Internet service provider. The full form of ISP is Internet Service Provider. ISP is Internet Service Provider. What does GB stands for? GB means gigabyte. GB means gigabyte. The short form is GB, full form gigabyte. What does GB stands for? If a computer is said to have 20 GB hard drive, right? What is a group of web pages called? Group of web pages is called website. The group of web pages is called website. Now here are some question answers already that we have done. Exercise of your chapter. These are 10 question answers that already we have discussed. So, students, you have to complete this exercise in your notebook as well as in your copy. Today, we have done 2 chapters, that is chapter 31. Scientific terms, scientific instruments, and 32, that is techno terms, the terms which are used in the computer. You have to learn both the chapters and you have to complete your book work as well as your notebook. Learn both the chapters. With this, your work is over. Thank you. Have a nice day.